So welcome all. So in this video, I'm going to introduce myself and I'm going to introduce my course called IP Addressing and Submitting and what you will be learning in this course, and then some more in detail about these things. So let me just introduce the course here. Now here you can see it's a course on IP Addressing and Submitting, where we'll be learning what are the basics of IP addressing, and also we'll be learning some advanced basic submitting, and also we'll get into some advanced submitting things. So you can learn this course free of cost. You can subscribe and you can download. The good thing about this course is you can subscribe to this so that you can watch them online from any place, and also you can easily download these videos, so you can easily download and copy them to your desktop, to so that your laptops, and you can watch them at your leisure time. So now why I just made a separate course here. So the main reason to make this course here is to ensure that the most people who are preparing for your CCNA, CCNT or ICNT1, ICNT2 exams, probably they find this submitting part as one of the most complicated part, because really, because you know, we get into submitting calculations, they are more into, there are more complex things, which I found many people who are doing CCNA, they find one of the most complex parts. So I try to use some simple, easy examples, and I tried my best to make the submitting as easy as I can. So probably you'll find those things in the coming sections. Now the good thing about this course is you have some multiple sections covered here. In these multiple sections, like I divided them into four sections here. So in these four sections, the first section is covering basics of IP addressing, where I'll give you very good foundations on IP addressing, even if you don't know what is IP address. So once you listen to these videos here, you'll get a very good understanding on addressing, where why we need IP addressing in the lecture 1. In the lecture 2, I introduce the different classes. And in the lecture 3, I discuss some differences between private and public addresses. So I have something around more than 17 lectures with something around 5.5 hours of contents, where I'm going to introduce to submitting. And by the end of the course, you will be able to subnet a network in your head. And finally, I'll be discussing about your private and public IP addresses. What's the difference and why we need a private and public IP addresses. So mostly in the section 2, you'll get introduced to your subnetting, and you'll be very much comfortable with all the submitting calculations, especially FLSM here. And in the section 3, we'll get into some advanced submitting calculations. We'll do some basic VLSM, and then we'll get into some VLSM shortcut methods, and finally we'll do some complex calculations on B class and A class as well. And in the last section 4, I try to put some submitting questions, and where I took some sample examples, and we'll be doing some submitting calculations. Like I took some examples like 192.168.10.10. Whenever you see this address with a submit mask of /26, you should be in a position to identify the submit mask, the range of the addresses, where it starts, where it ends, all those things. And then I try to put some more advanced calculations here with some more complex submitting calculations. And then finally, in the last lecture, I try to put some scenarios, some real scenarios, how we can use the subnetwork when you are designing the networks especially. So how you need to plan and ensure that how the best practice to design your networks by using the subnets. And then finally, I put on some questions here in the IP addressing and quiz paper here. And then finally, there is one more topic which is going to summarize all the contents, whatever I discussed. Okay. So now the good thing about this course is who can attend. The people who are looking for CCNA, especially the network administrators, not only CCNA, those who really find difficulty in understanding and calculating the submitting, they can really use these things. So regarding myself, so I'm Sikandar Gauss Mohinuddin. I'm certified in CCIE, Routing, Switching and Service Forwarder Trunk. So I have been into production network for more than 10 years. I have been working as a network consultant as well as a senior technical instructor and training CCNA almost more than 8 years. I have been in training CCNA. So I generally work as a consultant, and then I also do as a trainer, where I'll be doing some trainings on CCNA, CCNP and CCI certifications in both routing, switching, and service border tracks. Okay. So you can just watch my profile here. So I'm certified. This is my CCI number, certified in CCI RNS and service border here. And also did some Microsoft certifications initially before I got into Cisco specializations. Okay. So I work as a freelance Cisco instructor, and I'm responsible for many corporate trainings in different locations. Like there are some of the corporate clients which are trained initially. So still I'm doing some trainings on this. So I'll be doing some worldwide delivery authorized Cisco trainings from CCNA to CCI level, routing, switching, and service border tracks, especially for major Cisco learning partners. Okay. So these are some of my roles and responsibilities. And I just try to list some of the core networking skills which I'm specialized. These are all the core networking skills. Okay. So you can get in touch with me on Facebook. So you can just come down to this site, facebook.com. This is my profile, where you can get in touch with me on the Facebook. You can even drop me a mail on my personal email ID. Okay. And even these are my personal email IDs I just listed out here. And you can even follow me on Twitter. So I'll be using the same Sikandar CCIE, my Twitter account. Okay. Not only that, you can also follow me on my new website, which will be networkonlineacademy.com. So which is an online training method where you'll be stay updated with all the updating course which I'll be doing in my next couple of months. So I'll be updating more courses on CCNA, CCNPs, as well as CCIE, and you can watch them on udemy.com as well. And even I do some online training sessions also.